The student section is ready to turn this place into a cauldron of noise. Rice-Eccles Stadium, home to the Utah Utes. Today, a ranked versus ranked matchup as a couple of top 25 teams get set to go jaw to jaw. As we'll see, the number 16 team in the country, the Arizona Wildcats, taking on the 12th ranked team in the land, the Utah Utes. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. Arizona will kick off to get things underway. Looks like he's going to try to return it. He was hoping for something a little more dynamic, but they get him on the ground at the 20. So the Utah Utes offense will get the first possession of the game. And here he comes, a man who epitomizes the phrase, the tight end's always open, David.
And yes, he is, Reese. And it's so cool. The tight end position now has evolved so much. You can move him all over the field, and you can really highlight a guy of his ability.
Too big for safeties to cover and too fast for linebackers to cover. This is a weapon they've got to take advantage of.
And I love working the slot receivers, and you see so much of that. It's about matchups, right? I can put a fast guy in that slot, maybe get him matched up on a linebacker or a safety. I like working those guys in those matchups. Favorable for the offense, for sure.
Now on first down from the 30. They go to the ground. Works his way to the 41, and that is plenty to give him a first down.
And a great job by the offensive line. You're going to run the ball right at the middle. You better control the line of scrimmage. You can see the center, the guard, the tackles doing a good job getting on their guys just enough where this running back can get into space and make the big gain.
They are dialed in on this drive. A couple of chunk plays, and now they'll snap it on first down. Might as well give it to him again. They'll pick up 4, second and 6 coming.
I know that wasn't a big, huge play, and everybody's not excited, and the fans aren't going crazy, but those are the plays that in the fourth quarter matter a lot. Again, making you tackle my back, making you feel the physicality of the football game throughout, so you get tired and get worn down in the fourth quarter.
Solid pickup of 4 on first down and 2nd and 6. At the 45 on its way. Offense on the move. A big play there. Gets it to the 30.
I think it's really important for this offense. They get this guy going early in the game, and they're doing a nice job of that right now. Remember, he's the kind of running back who gets better as the game goes on. That's a really good omen for this offense, considering his success now early.
And the Utes have it with a 1st and 10. The offense showing motion from the tight end, trying to get a read on the D. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. Wrestled down at the 26, it's a gain of 4. After the productive first down play, it's 2nd and 6. Here's the handoff. Worked it down to the 22-yard line, giving 5 on the carry.
I think you run that play on 2nd down knowing it's going to make 3rd down easy. You're not trying to hit a home run. You don't need the big play right now. Now you know 3rd down, everything's on the table. Everything's available. High success rate.
Ball's at the 22. 3rd and short coming. Can the defense force him to settle for a field goal? And he'll step across the sidelines after making a good gain on that one.
One of the most difficult things about this slot receiver is his shiftiness and his athleticism. He's very, very difficult to tackle after the catch.
Just inside the red zone, 1st and 10 from the 19. Trying to cap this drive with a pass. Going for it all. And it's incomplete as he was trying to make the play in the back corner of the end zone.
Nice job by the defense there, taking all throws away from the quarterback. He had nowhere to put that football in the field to play, so that ball obviously had to go out of bounds.
And after the incompletion on 1st down, this offense looking at 2nd down. They move the tight end all over. Trying play action, getting some heat. And boy, was that pressure in his face immediately. Down he goes.
When you're on defense and you get to play outside linebacker, it's about as good as it gets, right? I get to rush the passer just like this and put him on the ground. Then I get to cover in space. I get to move all over the place. Great job by the outside linebacker. The most fun position to play in college football.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, but they'll have to convert third and long to keep it going. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. Couldn't find a man and just had to throw it away to avoid a negative play.
I'll tell you what, I don't know if the offense was expecting man coverage that time. Third and long in field goal range, you're expecting it to be zone. Instead, they lock him up man-to-man, everybody on an island, everybody won. They get the incompletion, now setting up fourth.
They'll send out the kicker here. He's going to try to punch one through from 45 yards away. It's good. Easy call for the refs. And the first points of the day come on that field goal.
Well, this team knew coming into tonight's game, they had to get momentum early, playing at home. They want to get the crowd into it. So you get a beautiful drive here to start this thing. You would have liked to cap it off with a touchdown, but listen, you set yourself up for a field goal. You knock it through the uprights. You've got the lead. Everything right now looking good.
So they were able to put up a three spot on that last drive, and now the kickoff team out there as they prepare to put boot to leather. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. So the Arizona Wildcats offense taking the field, first chance we have to see them today. When a guy gets off the ball as quickly as he does, you know he's going to be breathing down your neck, and you got to get rid of it, Jesse.
This quarterback's good, but he better have a clock going off in his head. He knows he's not going to have a lot of time to get rid of the football. That's a big matchup in this game.
Well, taking a shot on the first play. Snatches it on the right. And the tackle is made, but not before that completion gets him 30-plus.
Well, this guy's going to make catches all over the field. That time, he lined up all the way to the left side, and he was able to cross the entire field to make a catch on the right side. Defense lost track of him, and it ended up being a big play.
They weren't able to get that one off. It'll be a delay of game. The offense couldn't get the snap off in time, and it'll cost them. This crowd, full throat, splitting the eardrums and letting them know it's going to be a long day. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
And the number one thing you want to do with a jet sweep is make that thing bounce, right? Don't let it get outside right now. Make that thing go east-west, not north-south. Great job by the defense being ready for that jet sweep.
Here comes the offense on second down. The run to the left. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
Defense is about seeing it and pulling the trigger. And you could tell they pulled the trigger so fast. Get to the back, get him on the ground quickly.
Here comes this home crowd as the defense tries to get off the field on third down. Looking downfield, it's Fifita. He took a hit as he threw it and couldn't deliver the football. It's incomplete and fourth down's coming.
Oh, you know what time it is when the defense gets that stop on third down. Fist up in the air. Nice job getting to the quarterback, putting some pressure on him, hitting him, forcing the incompletion. Fourth down, baby.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. The Utah offense returns ready to go back on the attack. They kicked a field goal on the last drive, Jesse. They've got the lead. Don't make a dumb mistake, but maintain your aggressive play calling.
Yeah, no doubt. And I think it's the play caller right now just taking a look at that script he's got in front of him and finding out, where are my playmakers? Who can we take advantage of on this defense to get a touchdown here, man?
Yeah, and just keep moving the ball down the field. Just execute a little bit better in the red zone. There's no need to panic. We're moving the football, and we got the lead.
And here comes the offense on second down. power football with the run. That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there.
Well, man, there's some big hitting going on in the trenches right now. This defense, they take a lot of pride in stopping the run. Let's keep our eye on them throughout the course of the game and see if they can contain this running attack.
As they come to the line on third and short from the 43, I wonder if they already know they'll go for it if they don't make it here. And he's a real nowhere man tackled in this no-gain land. The Utes will line up to punt it away. Couldn't get away from that cover team, and they've got him down at the 23. Arizona sending the offense onto the field. Receiver on the move gets the touch pass. He is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose yards on that one.
The first thing you have to do to make these plays successful offensively is I have to block the edge. I got to get my speedster in space. They didn't do a good job of getting that guy out there in space where he could really use his jets. Nice job by the defense understanding it, seeing it, rallying to it, and tackling that guy for a loss.
Guys, that's the end of the quarter, and Utah has the lead here. We've played one. Before we move on, let's have a look at the stats. Heading in the opposite directions now as we crank it up in the second. They'll give it to the back. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
And that's a great play by the defensive end. The best athletes on the field play defensive end. You can ask anybody. Yes, I agree, Jesse Reese. See, they agree with me. Same thing. But you watch them get off the football, make the play. That's why you put your athletes there.
This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. Setting up the screen. And he was able to get away from one tackle, but plenty of help was on the way. Decent pickup on that play. They allowed the completion, but this defense was swarming to keep them away from that first down line.
Yeah, and you allow completions in those third down situations underneath the sticks, and you come up and rally, and everybody flies to the football. That's great execution by this defense.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. Might have thought he'd want to try to pick up a few yards there, but he's content with making the fair catch right around the 35-yard line. Using his legs, it's Bernard. And you want to talk about gang tackling. Everybody on the defense, run to the ball. Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. Give to the running back. And he doesn't find much running room. A short gain on the play. How bold will they be on third down after that last run? They try to pop a run on the draw. Almost got to the sticks on third down. Able to pick up 6, but they're looking at a 4th and 1. And the Utes will call on their punt team. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. And the punt hits at the 6, and they can't down it, and it'll be a touchback. Arizona has it back. The offense coming out to bear down. He'll pull it on the read. Not a whole lot of progress made there on the short run.
It's a nice job by this defense. Understand, listen, that QB is a threat. And they're going to run all kinds of options. He's going to run the football. They were dialed in and got that stuff to the ground.
This offense has a 2nd down play. Maybe some confusion on the snap count. It's going to be a false start. So the decision has been made, and the coach will take the penalty. Now on second down. They'll go to the ground. He found a hole, got about five. He's down at the 21.
Just a simple power play. Power football. Be strong, be big, be physical. Make it a fourth quarter game. Make them feel you. Keep them off balance.
Better find the air plugged. Here comes the noise. Backing this defense on third down. Back to the ground with the running back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Goodness gracious, if you blinked, you missed it. Horrible blocking up front. Defender gets in there so fast.
Did he line up in the backfield?
Arizona runs out the punt team. That's usually prime return position, but he'll make the fair catch just outside the 40. Utah has it back on the offense coming onto the field. He'll keep it himself. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
How about the defensive end understanding football? Understanding that I got to keep outside contained. I'm responsible for the quarterback. Good job playing his responsibility. And how about getting that sucker on the ground? He's a pretty good athlete to be able to corral him, tackle him right in the middle of the field, and get him to the ground.
They'll put the tight end in motion. To the ground with the back. Running with power. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, he was trying to do it all by himself. At the end of the day, it's a tackle for loss.
The number of tackles he broke, at some point, somebody's got to get blocked to help the guy out a little bit.
Man, the defense was like a bunch of zombies on that last play. They just would not stop chasing that ball carrier.
And the running game has gone in the wrong direction. The offense tries to turn it around and go forward on third down. He'll try to do it himself. And boy, is he close to that first down, maybe just a couple of inches short.
These guys aren't human anymore. I mean, they got to survey the field, throw the football, make deep passes, and then guess what else? They pull the ball down, take off, and make big chunks of plays on the ground. It's just impossible to be on defense nowadays.
The Utes will bring the punt team onto the field. Punt goes out of bounds, and a really nice job as they stick them deep in their own end. They'll mark it around the 10. He leaves it with his back. Good pickup on the ground there. Give him 5 to the 16-yard line. Halfway there on first down, it's 2nd and 5. Out of the gun, the inside give. They shut it down quickly, but he gets 2 out to the 18.
They're strong and they're strong. Defensive tackles, they're strong. They're such big jokers in the middle where they just lock out those offensive linemen. And running backs, listen, they don't have much of a chance. When you got that 300-plus pound guy grabbing you around the shoulder pad, you tend to go to the ground pretty quickly.
You've got a 3rd and manageable backed up in your own end, but convert here and you get some momentum. To the air, it's Fifita. Delivers the contact, and he surges up to the 36-yard line, and they'll move the chains. These two guys, just on the same wavelength, they make clutch connections all the time.
And that's practiced, man. That's all summer. That's all spring. Just so many hundreds and hundreds and thousands of balls where you know exactly when that guy's going to break. You know he's a stud. You're going to feed him, especially on these third down situations.
Going up top on first down. Catch in the middle. It's McMillan. They make the stop, trying to pick up just a little bit at a time to get to that first down marker.
I like the decision by the quarterback here. Just get the ball out of your hands. Get it to your playmaker. A lot of times he'll dance and make even bigger plays than he did here, but it was still a positive game.
Clock's running, and they'll try to get to the line warp speed for second down. He's looking to throw. Downfield. Boy, did he look as if he was going to go. Gets it down to the 37. There's a timeout called as this offense tries to find a way to draw a little closer. The Wildcats will line it up on first and 10. They keep attacking through the air. Quickly to the tight end. And just a short, safe pass play, they pick up a few.
It must be nice for this quarterback knowing he's got this type of athlete playing the tight end position. He can work the middle of the field for him. He's a guy who can stretch it vertically as well, but this is a guy QB will look for early and often in this game.
They've got him spread out on second and 7, two wide out to either side. Got his man on the right. He is down at the 1. A terrific run after the throw and catch. We've got a timeout here late in the first half, and they'll try to get more points on the board before the break. And guys, how much better does it feel if you go to that locker room with a lead? They have it. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Arizona.
And that is exactly what you want from your offense. Man, late in the half, you want to execute and then punch it in physically on the ground. Take the lead going into the half. Take all the momentum. Nice execution on the drive by that offense.
Ready to try the point after. And the extra point makes it 7-3. So they got the touchdown, now going to put it in the hands of their defense to finish off this half. And he takes this from inside the 5. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Utah offense returns ready to go back on the attack. Going for it all. Makes the catch and a huge play on the left side. And a pickup of better than 30 yards on that completion before the defense brings him down. The offense will quickly use a timeout. This attack so lethal with that big play capability. Now first and 10 from the 29. To throw, it's rising. Deep shot for the end zone. Intercepted. And they get the takeaway and prevent points from going up just before the end of the half.
What a big game-changing play. I love when you see defensive players, they jump on the ball like they were the offensive guy. So aggressive. Going and getting that pick, creating some big mojo for your team.
Running out of time here in the first half, they're going to have to be efficient to put some points on the board before the break. Hands it off. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. That's going to wrap up the first half here, and now we join Kevin with the halftime update.
All right, guys, a delightful first two quarters today from there in Salt Lake City. And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top. And with that, let's send it back to the fellas at Rice-Eccles Stadium.
Looks as if we're set to crank it up here in the second half. Here he comes from inside his own 5. Smashes through the tackle. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Starting this third quarter on the ground. Stacked up after gaining a couple to the 23. Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. He'll do it himself. Nice, solid form tackle from this sophomore. Man down on the play as the officials take a break to let him be checked out. They come to the line facing third and long from the 25. Looking to pass, it's Fifita. Unloads to the wideout. Got his man downfield. Good, solid pickup on that one. They've got it out to the 40, and it's first down.
This is exactly why third down is practiced every single day. Third and short, third and medium, third and long. It's money down for a reason. You got to lock in. Great success by the offense so far on third down.
Arizona in a hurry. Off the play fake on first down. He's taking the shot. And the DB forcing the incomplete pass with the deflection.
Nice job in coverage there. Offense trying to take a shot downfield. The defender able to tip that one up in the air and force it incomplete.
No gain on first down after the incompletion. Now second and 10 from the 40. From the gun, they'll try the middle. Only a couple there, and now staring at third and 8. They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. From the gun, the running back tries to hit the hole. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
Goodness, that is the way you blow up a play, quick, fast, and in a hurry.
Hair on fire caused a wreck. That had to be a blown assignment. The Wildcats will have to send out the punt team. They'll look to pin them deep. Signals for the fair catch, and that's where they'll put it in play, just outside the 20. Utah has it back, and the offense coming onto the field. The sledding has been tough. Scores have been at a premium, Jesse, and every possession seems like it could switch the momentum of the game.
Yeah, Reese, for this offense, just feels like they just haven't been as physical. And for this offensive coordinator, David, he's having to go deep into the playbook just to try to generate a first down.
Well, and the good thing is there's not a ton of game pressure because the other side's not scoring either. But if you can find that one thing that get that one positive play, and then maybe you get those juices going and something can start to build.
Works ahead for a couple. They'll stop him at the 27. Fairly manageable distance here on third down from the 27. Dropping back, it's Rising. He's got his man. They'll keep this drive moving by picking up the first down. They have it at the 36.
Man, that quarterback knew that was a tiny window to throw into, and he just showed off his cannon of an arm.
And the Utes will snap it on first and 10. Takes the handoff. It's Bernard. He puts him in business across the 50 into the 46-yard line. It'll be first down.
Every offense wants to be able to run the ball and be physical, especially on first down. And you want to create second and short, third and short, or just get first downs like that run right there.
The Utes are on the move. Right back to the well. And he'll pick up one. It brings up second and 9. Went with the running game on first down, now back at it. Looking for a physical attack from the gun. And a good, solid pickup before the defense cuts him down.
I think you run that play so you stay out of third and long. Third and long is not where an offense ever wants to thrive. Third and medium, hey, I'm good with that. So you run that play to make sure you're set up for a good third down.
Here comes a third down situation, and the defense has had no answer so far. They'll try to pick up the first through the air. Caught near the sticks. It's Parks. And he's out of bounds, but not before a good, sizable pickup, and that has been a rare sight in this one.
And as a defense, how scary is it having to defend this guy? He's one of the fastest players in America, and you saw it on that last play. It's not necessarily throwing him the ball over your head. They just get it to him quickly. The hard part now is running and tackling that guy. Not easy to do.
Back to throw. It's Rising. They're bringing heat. And a little too much adrenaline on that throw never gave his receiver a chance. Operating in the red zone here on second down. Movement here from the tight end. Hand off from the shotgun. They'll give him 4 yards on the carry. It's down at the 8-yard line. They'd love to pick up this third down and get a fresh set with first and goal. And he's not going to get there. The defense stands tall and makes the stop.
You know, I really like this QB running the football because I know he's got a lot of speed, but he's not the biggest guy in the world. So he's not going to be able to break a lot of tackles. You really got to do a good job of trying to scheme ways to get him out in more space.
And they'll send the field goal team back out for the second time tonight. It's good. He hit that one right down the middle. They'll kick it away after putting up a field goal on that last drive. And he'll bring it out of the end zone. Not nearly as much as he'd hoped when he brought it out of the end zone. He'll be stopped at the 15. Arizona sending the offense onto the field. He'll start this drive firing. And the pressure gets him back at the 8-yard line. And in a low-scoring game like this one, David, every possession is magnified.
And I think more than anything, it just gets frustrating. And you got to put that behind you. You got to see what this defense has been doing to be so successful. Caller, now use it against them.
Yeah, David, I think for a play caller, this is tough, right? It's like you have to get the perfect play on just to get a first down. In these types of games, I think you're just trying to get guys out in space. See if a dude can break a tackle. Maybe that generates an explosive play, and it breaks this trend.
Quarterback on the keeper. And he is swarmed under a host of defenders there to make the stop.
Well, they try to go quarterback design run on that play, but the defense just not buying it. Nice job, everybody playing downhill and making a tackle close to the line of scrimmage.
They've got them pinned deep in their own end, and this crowd trying to help keep them there. On third and long, hoping to throw beyond the sticks. Hines is back in the middle. And he's not going to make it. The defense denying him the first down.
You got to love that. On defense, one of the most critical statistics out there is how do you play on third down? How do you prevent the opponent from keeping drives alive? Right there, tackling the catch. You gave up the completion. Whoop-de-doo. You set up fourth and long. You're going to get the ball back. Go get some water and celebrate.
Another punt on the way. Got to make sure those hammies and glutes all activated. Don't want any muscle pulls from overuse. That's the end of the quarter, and Arizona has the lead here. They've done the work to build a nice cushion. Now to bring it home as we check out the stats after three quarters. One more period to go to see who can make the winning plays and come home with the victory. The Utah offense returns ready to go back on the attack. They had to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse. They'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to execution, too. Did a nice job out in the field, stalled a little bit once they got down to the goal line, so they just need to be a little bit more crisp here.
Yeah, and listen, I think the first part was the most important part. You got to put the drive together first to get down there. Now, when we get down there, focus on execution and getting 6 points.
Now it's a first down from the 43-yard line. Used the play fake, now to throw. Caught in the backfield, it's Keithy. Sometimes your tight end's a safety valve and sometimes he's your go-to receiver.
And the offense knew right away it was the primary target, it was where he was going with the football, because you know you get a little bit of suck up from those linebackers with the play action and you feed the big fella.
They'll line up for a second down play. Moving the running back, trying to get the D to tip its hand. Got it behind the line. It's Keithy. And that is a nifty bit of navigation to get through that traffic and get the first down.
Well, I know the tight end did some good things after the catch, but got to give the quarterback credit, too, for the location of the throw. Because he put it out in front of his big man, he was able to make the catch and accelerate, creating some distance there between him and the defense.
Looking to go up top on first down. Got it in the middle, it's Parks. They stop him almost immediately. Short gain there, and still a little ground to cover to pick up the first.
This offense has their work cut out for them, man, because the coverage has been so tight. And if you're not throwing to the sideline or you're not getting past the sticks, this defense is going to tackle you inbounds like they just did on that last play and bleed the clock.
The offense showing motion from the tight end, trying to get a read on the D. Running back searching for a hole. Able to make the stop after a gain of 2 to the 22. Third and short from the 22. Is the field goal unit getting ready, or is this already four down territory? Off the bootleg, looking to fire. He's got it! Touchdown, Utes! And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the fourth.
I think one of the most underrated things we talk about with a QB is timing. Being able to get the ball out of his hands to his receiver where he can continue to catch the football and run with it. Nice pitch, nice catch, nice play in the fourth quarter when you needed it for this team to take the lead.
Now the two-point conversion attempt is coming. Looking for a man. It's Rising. And he snatches it and comes down in the end zone for the two. So that scoring drive took only 6 plays. And the scoring play comes on a touchdown pass from 22 yards out. The kickoff team out there set to boot it away. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Arizona has it back, the offense coming out to bear down. The inside handoff. Just gets it to the 28, pickup of 1.
How about this defense rising to the challenge? Focal point number 1, stopping the great running back. Check. How do we do it? Being physical at the line of scrimmage, getting off blocks, not missing a lot of tackles. They have checked all of those boxes and shut this dude down.
Some misdirection with the counter. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3.
And this offense has to find a way to run the football. They got to get more creative, but whatever that looks like for this offense, something to jumpstart them, because nothing really going on the ground.
Yeah, defensively, though, you got to give them credit, too, because they knew that physically they were going to try to be challenged up front. That was a big MO for this offense coming into it. But the defense, they've risen to the occasion. Their front.
And he is snowed under, sacked at the 7.
Well, when the offense goes empty, that triggers the defense to want to blitz. The linebacker came that time. They couldn't get him blocked, and down goes the QB.
Arizona runs out the punt team. Three and out, they got stuck in reverse. They hope the punt can bail them out. So from the shadow of his goalpost, he gets the punt away. Really good job by the coverage team to make the stop, and that's where they'll put it in play. Utah has it back, and the offense coming onto the field. Off play action on first down. He lets one fly deep. Touchdown, Utah! And once he found daylight, it was Katie bar the door, baby. Quarterbacks love receivers that can get separation, but that amount of separation is a little excessive.
I agree, Reese, and I think the defense needs to have a little powwow on the sidelines and talk about what just happened, because that was an absolute busted coverage on the back end. Defense can't keep playing like that.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point is true, and they have a 2-touchdown lead, up 14 in the fourth. They're just about ready to kick it away. Out of the end zone. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Arizona sending the offense onto the field. Scanning the field, it's Fifita. Stands in and takes the hit. And it slips through his fingers, incomplete. That would have been a huge gain if he could have squeezed it.
Yeah, and I think you know the situation as a defender, and you know you're up by a score, and you know exactly what's going on with the offense. They got to make some big plays here in the fourth quarter. Nice job playing the deep ball, staying deep, and not giving up the big play.
Out of the gun to give to the back. Get some work done there. Pick up a 4 to the 22.
It's a nice game, but the big theme here is they just haven't been able to get the run game going on offense. They've been very one-dimensional, and they're just not being physical enough at the point of attack.
Decibels rising as the crowd gets behind this defense on third down. Off the play fake. And it's incomplete. Good play downfield by the DB.
Well, I like the aggressive nature by the quarterback there. He's trying to take a shot down the field. Just a better play by the defense forcing the incompletion.
Coach has no choice here. The offense has to stay on the field, down multiple possessions this late. Fourth down attempt coming. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. Incomplete on fourth down, and man, did they need to keep that drive alive. Splitbacks here. They'll start this drive with a pass. Pocket starts to collapse. The defense wouldn't let him loose, and even though it's a completion, they lost yardage.
I want to make sure I know where the playmakers are. And I can't let guys like this guy slip out of the backfield and make big plays against me. Good job being aware that they can throw the ball to the running back, closing space and getting that fast dude on the ground.
Smart move to keep it on the ground. Showed off just about every move in the book, except the forward move. Stopped for a short gain. Third play of the drive, and they need to take advantage of this field position by making something happen on third and long. On the move, it's Bernard. And Shore tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker. We've reached the 2-minute warning, and this offense is that much closer to salting away a victory. And this kicker has had a busy night. The field goal unit is out there for the third time. And if they can make this and turn it into a 3-score game, they'll have this one all but locked up. Never a doubt. And they'll push that lead out a little further. That lead just keeps getting fatter, and this kickoff team doing a little running. He'll start the return inside his 5. And the coverage team gets the returner on the ground. Arizona has it back, the offense coming out to bear down. Not a lot of hope here, down 3 possessions late.
No, and I love this part as a pass rusher because I'm just pinning my ears back, getting to the quarterback. I know it's a pass every single time. Palmer, I'm trying to pad my stats. I'm sure you're just trying to stay up.
Well, we're definitely just trying to stay alive at this point, but you're also trying to build confidence, too, for your next opponent. If you can find some completions late in the game, even though it looks like you're going to lose it, it's all about building on the good things you do this week so that you're out executing at a higher level the next time.
Man, and that's a big missed opportunity for the running back. I'm trying to find ways to feature this guy and get him the football in space and not just hand it to him all the time. And tell you what, I'm a lot less likely to find those plays if he can't reel in those catches.
Wants to throw. It's Fifita. He wants a big play here late. He holds it in, and nobody's close. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped. And the best thing about this, the offense can't worry about the scoreboard. Just keep trying to make plays like that, Jesse.
I know a lot of people in the stadium probably feel like this game is over. Maybe it's been over for a while, Reese, but don't tell that to this quarterback and his teammates. They're still out there scrapping and clawing.
Looking to move it through the air. A strike downfield. They immediately call timeout, trying to preserve every second they can to try to rally here late. And the Wildcats will snap it on 1st and 10. They're looking to pass from the red zone. And the physical play there forces the incompletion on 1st down.
This defense has a lot of speed, especially in the secondary. You saw that speed. That defender got to that receiver so quick, and because of the hit, incomplete pass.
They'll try again on 2nd down after the incompletion. He's looking to throw. Caught over the middle. It's McMillan.
Nice job by the receiver on the in route there. And how about the speed? After he made his break, he was able to actually separate a little bit from the DB, helping out his QB on that one.
Clock is still running, and they have to get everybody lined up. They'll throw on 3rd and short. Got it. And he will score. Touchdown, Wildcats. So much about the passing game is about timing, execution, communication. And these two, that's a virtual textbook there.
And no doubt about it. And the receiver making plays for his quarterback, being dependable, running the route to the right depth consistently, does a great job running his route. Great result because of it.
They'll try to tack one more on their score. And the PAT will draw them 1 point closer. They're definitely up against it. Time running out, down 2 possessions. They'll try the onside kick. Not much drives more anxiety than waiting to see if the hands team can corral the onside kick, and they do. So with the late lead, they're ready to just drain the clock in victory formation.